Kellen DePew was born in Lexington, Kentucky, in 1968. His father, pop musician Buddy Holly, was said to have been disappointed by his son's appearance and was overall an inattentive father. Despite his father's lack of affection, however, his mother, television star Donna Reed, was a more attentive and thoughtful parent. Though she too was concerned about her son's perpetual blank stare, she often attempted to stimulate Kevin's mind by dressing him in bizarre costumes and encouraging him to play strange role games. At the age of 3, her brother, Kerry DePew, was born into the household, a true prodigy, despite having extremely short legs. Kerry was discovered by ruthless Hollywood agent Sim Poindexter, who turned him into one of Hollywood's youngest and most sought-after martial arts film stars. Kerry DePew's success at such a young age provided the foil to Kevin's desperate attempts at finding a successful career of his own. Following in his father's footsteps as a musician seemed the logical choice. Desperate to secure an agent, any talent agent, Kevin finally met Bubba Hickman.
At the Cabana Club in Miami, and it was a Saturday night. I don't know how he did it, or, you know, looking back, maybe he bribed somebody to do it, but it was standing room only, and I went out to sing Blue Velvet. Actually, it was the music Blue Velvet, but I'd written my own lyrics because I fancied myself sort of a lyricist, and the song was called I Changed It to Nude Photos, and, you know, man, that singing business, it's harder than I thought. I wanted to put the whole music thing behind me. What a nightmare. And so I was watching TV one afternoon and saw that they have professional sports where people get paid to play sports. And I thought, well, you know, that's great, that's perfect for me because I like sports and, you know, maybe I could get in on that and get some cash for it, you know. And so I started working on my basketball skills because I really liked basketball the best. Even though I'm only 5'4", I felt like, you know, I could overcome that with the weight and strength in my legs. And I practiced quite a bit, but, you know, basketball's a lot harder than I thought. Basketball thing didn't work out. I was a little depressed. And so I started watching television again. I get most of my ideas from television since I watch it so much. And I noticed the success and popularity of all these talk shows. And I didn't want to do one of these trash talk shows. So I thought, well, you know, why not do a political talk show? It's a presidential election year. The timing's perfect. I seem to have a good camera presence. And I talked the folks at the Public Access Channel into giving me a shot at hosting a political talk show. And it didn't really work out like I thought it would. You know, doing a talk show is a lot harder than I thought it would be. I'm your host, Kevin DePue, and this is our first show, so we couldn't book a guest. Normally, we would have a guest for this show. You'll have to pardon me, I'm a little nervous. This is an open forum talk show. We'll be taking calls at 263
0963. So burn those phone lines up. Today's topic is going to be the presidency. With 1996 being a political presidential year, we'll be discussing past presidencies, ones that have been failures and ones that have been successes. So that's 263-0963, and we'll be waiting for your calls. Ring, 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 ring. I think that's a call now. Hello, you're on Political Spotlight. It's Dave. Hi, Dave. What's your question for Political Spotlight this evening? He wants to know who my favorite president is. Well, that's an easy question, Dave. Let's consult the Good President book. William McKinley. He's probably my favorite president. The reason I like McKinley is, well, you can see he's a rather bold-looking fellow. That's not a bad outfit he has on. I liked McKinley's overall demeanor. There's really not much you can say bad about McKinley. He really didn't do very much as a president, as far as, you know, you don't really see a McKinley Boulevard or McKinley Highway or things like that. McKinley College, I don't think there's one of those. If there is, call in and tell me. It says here that he was a pillar of the community. Well, I can certainly see that. Look at the way he's posed here in this photograph. He certainly looks like a pillar of the community to me. But Dave, that's my favorite president. And since you were so kind to ask, we'll talk about my least favorite president right here. He's in here somewhere. This would be, oh, of course, the dastardly Millard Fillmore. What a bastard. You can just tell by the way. Well, they pulled the plug on Political Spotlight before the first show was even over. Apparently you can't say bastard on the air or something like that. I don't know what the deal was. But at that point I'd had it with performing in public in any sort of forum like that, and I thought I just need to get back to the basics and do something where I can work with my hands. And then it occurred to me that, you know, maybe I should be an auto mechanic. I mean, that would be perfect for me. I like cars, and I think that would be a lot of fun. But being a mechanic's a lot harder than I thought it would be. Starter on here. Just get this thing off from there. We'll fix this thing up. Starter off in here. Might have to use a little bit of elbow grease. You know, they don't make no elbow grease though. Ain't that a shame? If they did, it'd make my job a lot easier.
Kevin's failures were beginning to take a toll. Desperate to find something, anything in which he could succeed, he turned to drinking.